I just want to say thank you. Thank you for me. Thank you for all the rest of the ladies sitting at this table. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to be here together, to experience this positive experience, and to do our best tomorrow. Thank you for your guidance. Please bless us with your guidance for tomorrow. And let us have a beautiful night, and thank you. That's all I can say. Amen.
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 You hear what I said?
Having such a good time. I don't know what to say. I think he's jealous of me, huh?
Lunch, that was the first time when we actually, when I got to really get a sense of who everybody was, genuinely. Girls will put on a show, you know, and but Lunch, I felt like I got to really kind of see each person, who they really are, at least a little bit. There was a window into each of them. So it was great, you know, we had a great conversation about astrology.
When I was outside in line at the audition, so much was going through my mind, actually. There were so many beautiful, talented women coming up, getting in line, and just the anticipation of what's going to happen inside. We had no idea what to expect. All we knew was that it was an audition for a beauty contest.
During orientations, I was finally getting all the fogs out of my head, and I tried to focus on what needed to be done. And the task didn't seem very difficult, and so I was pretty a little bit more relaxed, because now I have a mission. So I was kind of rolling up here without a mission, because I didn't know what to expect.
That's why I didn't understand why I had butterflies. I didn't. When I was in the room, there was nobody who I particularly looked at and said, oh, that person, you know, I have to worry about. There's my competition. I didn't really feel there was any competition in the room, so I didn't get why I had butterflies. But I think just overall, just going and putting yourself out there, just those natural butterflies that you get.
After the day of events, the Miss All-Star competition contestants get ready for the night's activities. These seven lovely ladies prepare for girls' night out while staying on their P's and Q's. The attention at each spot as they intermingle with admirers and complete various tasks. The beauty is only second to their mission of requiring a title, $5,000, or the canary ring and a layout in King Magazine.
Feeling perky, swerving up in the club with a fat bottle E&J, Mr. Mudslide on my side. Now I'm feeling right,
trying to hit this blunt.
Now I'm feeling high, looking at the streets who keep looking at me. Advanced on the shorty, she had a big booty, telling Charlie Chase that she wanna get with me. So I bounced to the bar once more. I know you got some money, baby, so let's go to the back, so I can sip the yak and hit the cat. You know she said yeah, cause I'm a Trojan ass Mac. I came through flossing and I did it hella quickly. I bounced out and my pounding ass Billy. I'm keyed out like a player do frequently. I'm mobbed out, cause that's the way it's got to be. You feel me? Get your drink on.
Them, you know what I'm
saying? Oh, I had a great time last night. I was just bored.
I can't believe I allowed myself to get in this situation.
I can't believe I allowed myself to fall for it. You know, but it doesn't matter.
You still didn't answer my
question. I'm just not in a good mood, that's all. It's okay, I'm gonna go check and make sure all the phones work.
You didn't call your man?
No, I'm not calling him. He don't call me, I'm not calling him. Right.
So,
you're so funny last
so
night.
So, when did you want to dance
dancing,
like that?
You're so funny dancing and booty dancing up on the side.
Like,
no, tomorrow. I saw
no
that.
Way.
I've
done some, yeah. I've done some music videos, and they, you know, they always want you to do that booty thing that they do. You know what I mean? I don't have much of.
Was I really doing that? I must have been so.
Girl, you have ass for miles. You have booty for days. You have booty for days. You gotta show me. Promise me you'll teach me. Before the weekend's over, you have to teach me.
Which one?
Any of them.
Any of the booty.
Because you had the guys just circling around you, and I was like, now, if I was doing that dance, the whole house would come down. Okay, you know what I'm saying?
So you're gonna teach me. I should have been getting paid, huh?
Girl, I will pay you. I wanna learn the booty dance.
I'm in last night, but you can pay me too.
Well, I don't know about danger, but I kinda like it.
You like, so you did nothing.
Oh yeah, especially Mike Tyson.
No, she didn't say Mike Tyson.
Yes, I did, I love him.
Mike Tyson is a cancer too.
He's a cancer, he told me one time, he said,
you sensitive, huh? He said, you a cancer, I'm a cancer too.
I said, oh,
shoot, I got Mike Tyson sympathizing with me.
Oh, wow.
Now you know
so
you
beautiful.
Met.
So beautiful.
So beautiful.
Is that what it
said? He said bootyful.
Yeah, he caught me crying one time. Mike Tyson.
That
wow.
Is my
that is the first time I have
it's
ever
say,
heard that in my entire
it's
life.
Say, Mark if you Tyson. Were to date a sports player, which no. Sports player would you date?
What's wrong with you?
Somebody who's not married.
Well, that scratches out all
somebody who's not getting pulled in for something
well,
crying
a
rape or
player. Then they wouldn't be a sports player. It's got to be in the category.
No, I don't think there is a sports guy. I don't think there's one sports guy date. I mean, I'd let him take me out to eat.
Is Mike Tyson married?
Is he even a sports player?
He's a sports guy. He's an animal or what is it?
Is he married? No. Robin Lester.
So I have a chance.
I cannot believe this, but I'm hearing it.